How do online Indian stores like Flipkart, Amazon, and Snapdeal offer products at huge discounts? The internet has revolutionized the way we shop and is the panacea for all the hassles people used to go through while shopping. From avoiding the crowd to finding more varieties at your convenience, there are plenty of reasons to shop online rather than haggling on the streets. One of the reasons that attracts you more are the cheapest deals you get without hunting for them in a different markets. Offline vendors, on the other hand, often charge you at the fixed prices even after bargaining, while online sites can give you incredible discounts. Online Indian stores like Flipkart, Amazon, etc. offer outrageous discounts every other month. First, it was Flipkart initiating with Big Billion Days, which crossed $100 million in no time. Followed by other big giants in the Indian market are Myntra, Snapdeal, etc. and foreign e-commerce firms like Amazon, which didn't fail to make big impact on people with their unbelievable prices. However, as much as it has made shopping experiences simpler across the country, it has affected offline retailers significantly. Did this thought ever strike you that how these big online firms can woo the customers with their whacking discounts? Let's unleash the secret for you. Well, making money online is easy as compared to offline bases. Online stores have a larger geographical radius, which can be operated without a physical store. Even if they sell less volume, they can still grow with the profit they made. Most of the suppliers use dropshipping that holds and ship the stock directly to the customer, and the online firm in turn get further profit. So these firms do not need to keep large and expensive warehouses, which enables them to make a profit even after a huge discount. Online stores do not need mediators, which in turn reduces the overhead cost of offline retailers. Let's take a scenario. A manufacturer sells a television to a wholesaler for Rs. 10,000. This manufacturing cost includes labor costs, salaries, and other bills. The wholesaler sells it to a retailer, adding a profit of 20 to 25% at Rs. 12,500. Now the retailer will add a major hike of around 50 to 60% when selling it to the end customer. By now, the total cost of the same television is Rs. 20,000 just because it has exchanged hands. The online world works in a different manner and perhaps slightly smarter. The online seller makes direct contact with the manufacturers while cutting on wholesalers and retailers. They make bulk purchases and get the same television at Rs. 10,000. They put an astonishing hike of 100 to 300% profit, or it can even go to 700 to 1000% depending upon the popularity. Even if they put a profit margin of 300%, the TV will be priced at Rs. 30,000. E-commerce businesses then wait for special days like festivals, etc. to give a bumper offer of around 60 to 80%. Now, after a discount of 60%, the same television will now be available at Rs. 12,000. Because of the limited time period urgency, this will sell around thousands of pieces, making them a profit of 50 to 60%. The logistics department only charges Rs. 40 to 50 per product, which sounds decent irrespective of how big the discount is. Needless to say, the e-commerce market opportunities in India are in tens of billions. The bottom line is, despite the alluring offers that are just a few clicks away, it is benefiting both the parties. Nothing can replace the happiness of opening a package and hassle-free returns at the comfort of your home. Let us know in the comments, what do you prefer, purchasing from a local stores, or do you wait for the great deals on online platforms, and why?
Hello friends, we are excited to announce the launch of our digital library where our viewers can buy informative ebooks. We will keep adding new editions across all categories. The link is given below in the description. Also guys, don't forget to subscribe to Braintastic and press the bell icon.